Hi guys, what's up? It's Christy. Here I am with the APB video. However, this one is a little tutorial for anybody who likes plaid patterns. As you can see, I made this nice plaid pattern. I'm gonna show you how I made it. So, I'm just gonna go ahead and duplicate this or whatever. You don't have to do exactly what I did or anything, but I can't do anything about this part. I guess it's the boobs or something, but I'm not gonna be able to fix that. So yeah, I just put like shoulder boards or whatever on it. Now I'm gonna take everything off and show you from scratch how to do it. So I had already made a thing, another one. Oops, this one's blue. It's the same thing. I'm just going to show you how to do it. As you can see, you're going to be using a lot of lines. So, start with a blank canvas. Okay. Now what I did was just take a square and pick a color. So let's pick a color. What color? Pink? Maybe? I'm going to try to do something a little different because I'm feeling testy. But so take another square, squish it. Make it long, pull it over to like this spot. Now I put my opacity or whatever at 50%, fucking shit, at 50%. Okay, and then I just take it, I'll click, and I'll pull it over. Shit, it don't have to be perfect. Well, yeah, you can make it perfect. I don't think it's really that noticeable, to be honest. So I'm just gonna rush with this because I don't want to take too much of your time. I fucked up somewhere in there. So just take your control key, select all the lines that you just made. I'm gonna move them over. Yeah, because I messed up a little bit. But yeah, control click all of these, duplicate it, do your turn or whatever. Now this part, I'm not sure how I'm going to do it. So I'm going to pick another color. Let's go with that's teal. Let's go with this light blue. I did just take it and make it squishier than your first set of lines, and you're gonna put it like in the middle of this line, or I guess you could put it to the side, I don't know. I haven't experienced much with these patterns. You're just gonna do this all the way to the other side, and you're basically just doing the same thing again at this point. Now I'm gonna take them, duplicate. Turn them. See? That looks nice, right? Now this part's totally optional. You could keep that. You could do a little more with it if you want. What I'm gonna do, whoops, I think I passed it, is take these. I'm gonna outline it. I'm gonna make it squishy enough for, like, the lines. I wish I could show you. Like, these lines here to be in sync with the first set of lines, so you want to do it like this. But I'm gonna pick a different color. I don't freaking know what color. Teal, I guess, looks nice. And just take it all the way. And then, oops. And then you just take it and do the same thing again. So you don't have to use these colors, but you need to use like interchanging colors. Like you can use mostly white and black and then pick your third color. It really does look nice. So it's basically the same thing over and over unless you want to add something. I'm gonna duplicate it and then we'll do that and say it looks nice. Now some people could like you could do other things, like, you know, the squares where the lines meet, you could, like, put a block there for every square, but, I mean, we're already at, like, almost 50 things, so I'm going to save this, and I'm going to show you how to put it on a shirt. Make the buttons white. So when I put it on a shirt, I just make sure you do like buttons invert so that you can see your buttons. I'm gonna wrap it around the arm so I know how thin or skinny you want this to be. There may be a better way to do this now that I think about it. As far as getting that pattern right here on the chest to look right. So just take it and there's no way in hell we're gonna be able to do this perfectly, especially because the shirt glitches at the bottom. Just go up with it, make sure it matches. But that's basically how you do it. I mean, it doesn't look too bad. These are definitely unique colors here that I chose. I'm thinking that you could just take this pattern. Now, I haven't done this yet, and I'm doing it at, like the first time. Just take the pattern and like lay it down, and just lay it down, and that might look right. I think this might actually work. See, I think the problem will be like the sides mostly. That's where the problem will be. It's getting the sides to look right, but that does look nice so far, doesn't it? I don't know. Let's see, just do this or something. It's kind of a little crooked, huh? You don't have to keep watching this video, however. See, and now I gotta get the front to look like right match up with that. And it's not the shirt's not the collar's like fucked up. I guess you could do this, I don't really know. Fuck. I should put this like under all the other ones. Maybe no one will be able to tell. Let's do arms invert. See, but you gotta get it right here. Maybe you could do this and no one would be able to tell. This is just me experimenting as I'm making this video. Should probably make the video like really long. I'm really sorry. I think that does look really good, but I'm not enjoying these colors, so that's basically how you do it, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope I helped you somewhat. If not, I'm sorry this was no help to you, but you really do need premium to really get far with your symbols and stuff. So, again, you could make shoulder boards if your shoulders are really retarded, but I mean, it's not that noticeable. I mean, nobody's gonna be like looking at it that closely, but anyways, guys, this video has been very long, and I thank you for watching, and I'm sorry that this is like so fucking long. Bye bye.